What's up, tech fans? Today we're going to be looking at something that's small but pretty powerful, the Ace Magic Kron Mini K1 PC. So let's jump in and let's see what's inside this box, what this thing's all about, and at the end of the day, would you want to put this on your desktop and use it? Because at coming under $350, I think you guys are going to be pretty surprised. So let's jump into the video. Did you just buy a brand new computer or upgrade your old computer with so many parts it's now asking for a new Windows key and you don't have one? Well, check this out. VIP Your CD Key has you covered, and you don't have to pay Bill Gates that $199 price tag at all. You can get it right now for under $25, and it's easier than ever to do. All you do is you go over to the website. On their website, you create an account. After that, you go and find your software. You put your software in the cart, enter the code TOT20. It will give you a wonderful 25% discount. You go to the checkout. After you do the checkout, check your email a couple of minutes later. You will have the code in there. Put it in your computer and activate your computer. It's that simple. And check it out. All of these codes are guaranteed for life. So save yourself some money and check out the links below. All right, so first off, let's check out what comes in the box. We'll do a real quick unboxing right here. Shouldn't be too hard to do. Usually there's not a whole lot in these little mini systems. It's usually just what's in there. Some things that are nice about this though is that the NVMe memory that's in here, it actually has a couple of slots and it can be upgraded to even higher than the 32 gigabytes that are inside of it. So let's go ahead and let's just pop the little side panel here. Things that were going on here. We popping, we sliding. Okay, this one we're sliding. So now we're gonna slide this little thing out here. And once again, we've got a box. It says, guess what? Mini PC. I've been waiting the one that has a Y right here, and it comes with like a box of 10 little tiny ones and mini PCs. Bad joke. All right, I'm sorry. So here we're gonna open up the bottom of this thing because I believe this is still in camera range. Everybody can be seeing what's going on. So we're gonna pop the little top right here. Looks like this is probably going to be the accessories. So let's check that out. Okay, so yeah, this is the stuff. All right, so let's get in here and see this. Whoops. Oh, okay. HDMI connector. Got one of those bad boys right here. That's in the box. Toss it down. Backplate. Pretty cool. You could mount this to the back of your computer. Not bad idea for people who want to save space. Power cord. Need one of these, obviously. My dog's barking at the door. Sure, first she barked to get out. Now she barks to come back in. Here are the screws to hold that back in. And then lastly but not least, we have the little power brick itself. Plugs in. There's the other side. You guys can hear a lady out there barking her head off. But hey, that's what she gets. She literally scratched at my door and went nuts to get outside of the room when I was doing this. So, now she's gonna have to suffer. So let me take the plastic off this little thing. Da-da-da, da-da-da. Inside, AMD Ryzen 7. 5700U CPU, you've got Vega 8 graphics, 32 gigabytes of memory, a 1 terabyte NVMe hard drive, very fast stuff there. This thing's geared for both light gaming and it's geared for those people who want to do a lot of business things. Having 32 gigabytes of RAM and a 1 terabyte hard drive gives you lots of options as far as power goes, and it's so small. It honestly is even smaller than a Mac Mini. So let's go ahead and let's just open the plastic up on this and get the last bit of it off of here. And tear it all out there and yada, yada, yada. Okay, ba-boom. Ace Magic. On the bottom, we can see there's a place for air to be brought in. There's also vents on both sides. There are vents here on this side. And there are also vents here. This is to help dissipate all of the heat away from this particular system. It also comes pre-installed with Windows 11. So for all those people out there who do want to do gaming, you can do it. Now, this thing is not built for playing all your super duper demanding 3D shooters. It will play those CSGO, any type of third person down like Diablo, it'll play all of those type of games. I've actually tested a couple other PCs with these pretty much identical specs. So, I mean, showing a bunch of scores for these things is just, in my way, it just kind of just feels kind of silly because there's just so many people just throwing out numbers. So what I'm going to do is after I show you guys this, I'm going to go play with it for a while and then come back and give you my conclusion on it. So we also have two USB 3.0 second generation ports on the front. We've got the Type-C right here, and it looks like, even though I'm half blind, okay, so we got the power, the audio, two USB, and then the USB-C. Okay, yada, yada, yada. On the back, we've got a little thing that says, don't pull me off until you're gonna use me. Well, we're gonna show you guys what it is in the video, so we're going to have to just slightly pull it off. And there we go. And let's talk about that. So once again, we have four more USB 3.0 ports in the back here. Got your LAN port, HDMI, and I believe that you also have DisplayPort. Yes, so it's HDMI and DisplayPort. I'm probably gonna have to buy some glasses here pretty soon, guys. I had my aberration, I can see far away, but close-up stuff is still kinda half the time. So, and then here's where the power goes in. So it's very small. It fits in the palm of your hand. I mean, literally, look, this is my hand. It's smaller than my hand. It's very, very small. I can even balance it on my head and do a dance. The system also supports triple monitors, so you can have three monitors running at 60 frames per second through the DisplayPort and through the HDMI port, so that's pretty cool. And also with a 1 terabyte hard drive and with the amount of memory and everything that's in this, you'll also be able to run some of the latest AI software that they're having out there, which is becoming the biggest thing in the world. So I think that's pretty important. But with that said, let me go and test this thing and get back and give you guys a conclusion. See you guys in just a bit.
2 hours later.
Okay, so here it is, tech fans. Currently, this particular PC is coming to market at under $350. There's a coupon deal going on right now at Amazon. I will have a link down below. Another cool thing about this particular computer is it has a 3-year warranty and there's 24/7 customer support. That's right, I said it. 24/7 customer support from Ace Magic. So if you're having any problems at all with the system, they are gonna be there for you. Now, as far as gaming goes, like I said before, it is not going to play the craziest 3D titles and be able to blaze through those. But anything at moderate settings, especially through Steam, which is what I was just using for my gaming experience, most of the games that I were playing were coming at about 60 frames per second or less, depending on how I set the graphics. I couldn't set anything to ultra high, but some games you could play on high, some games you could not. I mean, honestly, I think this is gonna vary between the player, their monitor, and the settings that they have. So one of the reasons why I stopped just throwing a bunch of benchmarks out there is because a lot of times people just look at the benchmarks and what are, they're just numbers. You're like, oh, okay, it got this, it got that, it got this. And you go watch some other video and, you know, they're almost all exactly the same. And I got burned out on that, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'd rather just go use the computer and come back and tell you guys how it really did. For light gaming, for people who are using top-downs type stuff, if you're playing any type of game like that, like CSGO, PUBG, and all that type of stuff, any of those games that are out there are going to be able to be played no problem at all. If you want to play some higher titles, you'll be able to play them, but you're going to have to cut the settings down to a lot lower to have a great fluid gaming experience. Now, I opened up 60 windows. Close them, open them, close them, open them. I also, for kicks, for shites and giggles, I installed Pro Tools. Now, you guys are going, why would you install Pro Tools on that? Well, I want to install Pro Tools on it, hook up an external recording device and see how it actually did for recording studio, because some people out there are going, wow, a mini computer like that could really probably kick ass in my recording studio, but how did it do? And let me tell you, fuck yeah! This thing did absolutely great in the recording studio. I feel like Glenn Fricker over on Spectre. Yeah! Yeah! No, as far as doing that, it actually really did excel. It's completely silent. You can't hear it at all. And for those people out there who just will not touch a Mac at all, no matter what, they're just like, I'm not going to use an Apple product. I hate Apples. I won't use them, Elric. Don't even try. Well, check it out. This particular mini bad boy works good. I even had a bunch of instruments going. I hooked my keyboard up. I installed that. I played my keyboard using all the software. It had no problems whatsoever playing the files. All in all, for a little music mini PC for a recording studio, I give this thing 2 thumbs up. For gaming, it's okay. It's not really meant to be a serious gaming computer anyways. And if you're somebody who's in the office, I don't use AutoCAD, so I didn't test it with AutoCAD. I don't have Photoshop. When I do all my stuff, I have a Mac and I use it, so I wasn't really able to test those aspects. But I would just say this. For gaming, eh. I mean, to be all fair in gaming, it depends on what game you are. I would say B plus, maybe B. For studio stuff, I would give it an A, A minus. For business stuff, it's going to be an A, because no matter what I was doing, and like I was saying, I was opening up Word documents as well, you know, opening up all of this stuff, running the computer and constantly, it really didn't slow down at all for a couple of hours. So at the end of the day, I have to say, for the price and performance, this little Kron kicks butt, man. It's the Kron. What can I say? I mean, you out there who know what Kron is, you know what Kron is. This is the Kron. So there it is. I'll have the links down below if you guys want to check them out. Like I said, this is on sale right now, so you can get yourself a deal. And all those keys at the beginning of the video by VIP, your CD key, I personally guarantee that they will work for you. They have been advertising with me for over a decade, and no one's ever had any problems. If you like what you see, sub. Hey, if you don't, hey, I'd appreciate you if you just come back and watch another video. Love everybody no matter what. Peace.